the angel of the noble tidings to Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Ghost. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the mystery of an angel, so by his cross and passion may we come to know the glory of his resurrection, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, Amen. In tua ora tale Dei, et in quelli di fidei in contu tu meum. Iurica medesa, dicione canto meum, de gente non sancta, con nomine nel codo lo sorro, Amen. Quae tuus Deus fortibum corre pulissis quae suissis in cielo cum officium et micus. Et mi delucia in tua veritate in pugnim, si vedebus erum tu servum di mortum sanctum tuum et tabernacula tua. Et in tua ora tale Dei, et in quelli di fidei in contu tu meum. Ovide gutti vincitra, Deus Deus meus, quae tuis anima mea, quare in tuo persone. Sveri Deo quone a tuo covide bui, salutare putus me et Deus meus. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. In tuoi volontari Dei, et in quelli ti fica gli un tutto meum. Auditor nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci cielum et terra. Confiti in remi potenti via de Maria, sed Virgine via de Caleta, Angelo via de Cone Battisti, Santi Sposi di Spesa, et Paoli, Adio, Anima Dei, Via, Nomibus, Santi Sposi, Fratres, Quae ego da vini mis cogitazione per vota opere, meo culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ed io prego beata Maria, non sei vigile, inviato metale, ma che angelo, beato di Battista, un santo sposto spettro, Paolo, beato di buona Maria, di Anno, un santo sposto patres, ora ripome, domen un Deo nostro. Miseria, totune di potenza, Deo, se ci spettati, scrivi spirito, te, vita, l'eterno. Amen. Confiti, io Deo, mi potenti, inviato Maria, sempre vigile, inviato metale, che angelo, inviato di Juan Battista, i santi sposti spettro, Paolo, omnibus santi, se ti vivate, qui evo cavinimis cogitazione verbo d'opere, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ed io prego, beata Mariam, sempre Virgine, beata Michaela Macangelum, beata Ioanna Battistam, Sanctus Apostolus Petimus Paulum, omnes sanctos et te, Pater, ora le pro me, ad hominum Deum nostrum. Miseria tu vestri, nipotens, eus et mis peccatis vestris, petute vos et vitam aeternam. Amen. Indulgentiam, substitutionem et remissionem peccatorum nostrorum te vivat nomis omnipotens et misericus Dominus. Amen. Deus tu conversus perfectibis nos, et plenus tu electabitur in te, os tende nomis Domini misericordiam tuam, et salutare tuum da nobis. Domine exaudi rationem meam, et clamo meus et te veniat. Dominus obiscum, et in spirito tuo. Orne Prorate celi te super, et nubes pluant justum, aperiatur terra et geminet salvatorem. Celia erant gloriam Dei, et opera magnum eus annuntiat firmamentum. Prorate gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Prorate celi te super, et nubes pluant justum, aperiatur terra et geminet salvatorem. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax hominibus bonae voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te, gratia tangimus tibi propte magnum gloriam tuam. Domine Deus, Rex Celestis, Deus Pater Omnipotens, Domini Filii Unigenite, Iesu Christe, Domine Deus, Omnus Dei, Filius Patris, qui tollis peccatum mundi miserere nobis, qui tollis peccatum mundi suscipe deprecationem nostram, qui sedes ad dextram Patris miserere nobis, gloriam tu solus sanctus, tu solus Dominus, tu solus Altissimus, Iesu Christe, cum Sanctus Spiritu in gloria Dei Patris. Amen. Pax vobis et cum Spirito Tuo. Ordinus. Deus, qui de beate Mariae Virginis utero verbum Tuum, angelum nunciante carnem suscipere voluisti, prese supplicibus Tuis, ut qui vere eam genitricem Dei credimus, eus appetente cessionibus adiuvemur. Per liundum Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum Filium Tuum, qui tecum vivita regna ad unilitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Ordinus. Aurem Tuum caesimus Domine precibus nostris accomoda, et mentis nostri tenebras gratia Tuae visitationis illustra, qui vives et regnas cum Deo Pater in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Lex Isaiae prophetae, in diebus illis locutus est Dominus ad Achaz dicens, pete tibi signum ad Domino Deo tuo in profundum infermi, sive in excelsum supra. E dicit Achaz, non petam et non tentavo Dominum. E dicit, audite, ergo, Domus David, nunque parum vobis est, molestos esse hominibus, quia molesti estis et Deo meo? Propte hoc David Dominus ipse vobis signum. Ece virgo concipiet et parie filium, et vocabitur nomen eus Emmanuel. Utirum et melcom edit, uciet reprobare malum et eligere bonum. Deo gratias. Tolite portas principes vestas, et elevamini porte antenales, et introibit rex gloriae. Qui descendit in montem Domini, aut qui sabit in locu sancto eius, innocens manibus et mundo corde. Alleluia, alleluia. Ecce virgo concipiet et parie filium, Iesum Christum. Alleluia. Dominus obiscum et cum spirito tuo, sequentia sancti evangelii secundum Lucam, gloria tibi Domine. In illo tempore missus est angelus Gabriel ad Deo in civitatem Galilae, qui nomen Nazareth, ad virginem deponsatam viro, qui nomen erat Iosef, de domo David, et nomen virginis Maria. Et ingressus angelus ad Deum dixit, Ave, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus. Quecum audisse turbata est in sommone eus, et cogitabat qualis esset ista salutatio. Ed et angelus ei, ne timeas, Maria, invenis dienim gratiam ab Deum, ecce concipies in utero, et paries filium, et vocabis nomen eus, Iesu. Hic erit magnus et filius altissimi vocabitur, et David ili Dominus Deus segem David patris eus, et legnabit in domo Iacob in aeternum, et regni eus non erit finis. Dicit autem Maria ad Angelum, Homodo fiet istud, quoniam virum non conosco. Et respondens Angelus dicit ei, Spiritus Sanctus superveniet in te, et virtus altissimi umbrabit tibi. Id eo quae et quod nascetur ex te sanctum, vocabitur filius Dei. Et ecce Elisabet, cognata tua, et ipsa concepit filium in senectute sua. Et hic mensi sextus est illi, quae vocatur sterilis. Quia non erit impossibile ab udeum omne verbum. Dixit autem Maria, ecce ancilla Domini, fiat mihi secundum verbum tuum. Laus tibi Christi. This the feast of the expectation of the Blessed Virgin Mary. The lesson is taken from the book of the prophet Isaiah. At this time the Lord sent this message to Ahaz. Ask the Lord thy God to give thee a sign in the depths beneath thee or in the height above thee. But Ahaz said, No, I will not ask for a sign. I will not put the Lord to the test thus. Why then, said Isaiah, listen to me, you that are of David's race. Can you not be content with trying the patience of men? Must you try God's patience too? Since you will not ask, the Lord will give you a sign of his own accord. Behold, the virgin shall be with child and shall bear a son, and he shall be called Emmanuel. Fed on butter and honey, he will grow to the age of refusing what is bad, choosing what is good. And the Holy Gospel today is the continuation of that according to St. Luke. At this time, God sends the angel Gabriel to a city of Galilee called Nazareth, where a virgin dwelt betrothed to a man of David's lineage. His name was Joseph, and the virgin's name was Mary. Into her presence the angel came and said, Hail, thou who art full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. She was much perplexed at hearing him speak so, and cast about in her mind what she was to make of such a greeting. Then the angel said to her, Mary, do not be afraid. Thou hast found favour in the sight of God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and shalt bear a son, and shalt call him Jesus. He shall be great, and men will know him for the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he shall reign over the house of Jacob eternally. His kingdom shall never have an end. But Mary said to the angel, How can that be, since I have no knowledge of man? And the angel answered her, The Holy Spirit will come upon thee, and the power of the Most High will overshadow thee. Thus this holy offspring of thine shall be known for the Son of God. See moreover how it fares with thy cousin Elizabeth. She is old, yet she too has conceived a son. She who was reproached with barrenness is now in her sixth month, to prove that nothing can be impossible with God. And Mary said, Behold the handmaid of the Lord, let it be unto me according to thy word. Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Carissimi, beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast Mass on this, the Feast of the Expectation of the Blessed Virgin Mary. The history of this feast, in short, is that at one time, particularly in the church in Spain, because there was a prohibition and during the observance of Lent that no greater feasts should be celebrated during that holy season, the Feast of the Annunciation of the Blessed Virgin was sometime removed to this date, a week before the Nativity. You may recall, you may know, my brothers and sisters, that at various times the Church's discipline concerning the observance of Lent has varied considerably. You may recall that the period of Jessima, Septuagesima, Quinquagesima, Sexagesima, refer to times when our Lenten observance began longer than just the now 40 days, but sometime 50 days, 60 days, 70 days. at various times too. There were ways of observing Lent that at one time, in this particular case, meant that for a stricter observance, all other solemnities or greater feasts were transferred out of the season, so that all focus was on the season of penance and preparation for the Passion. So it was that this occasioned the removal of the Feast of the Annunciation to this date in December. Then sometime later, of course, the discipline changed and the Feast of the Annunciation was reinstalled for the 25th of March. And so this day continued to be kept in certain places around the world, particularly by the Iberian faithful, by the Spanish, becoming instead to them the feast of Our Lady of the O, or Our Lady of the Great O's, in part because of the O antiphons that I'm sure some of you will be familiar with that are now recited before the Magnificat during Vespers in this last week run up to Christmas. Otherwise, it became known as the Feast of the Expectation of the Blessed Virgin. So it is at this feast, of course, in almost mirrors that of the Annunciation. We have just heard the golden legend, as it is known, the Gospel for the Annunciation, that when Our Lady is informed by the angel Gabriel that she will give birth to the Saviour of the world, and in Vespers on this day, an antiphon, an O antiphon, is given that is also still retained in the Serum use of the Divine Liturgy, appearing there on Christmas Eve, but appearing for us in the Latin Rite Office, in the General Office, today for this feast. O Virgo Virginum, O Virgin of Virgins, which speaks too of the joy and the expectation of Our Lady. So it is that this Feast of the Expectation, and those of you who follow the blog wherein the propers of the Mass are given, perhaps have noticed that today's icon depicts Our Lady in her confinement, as pregnant, and a little vignette in her stomach of the babe, of the Bambino, of the Blessed Saviour, waiting to be born. And of course, our thoughts might turn to the expectation of Our Lady at this particular moment in history. And remember, my brothers and sisters, that we are talking about history when we are referring to the birth of our Saviour, when we are referring to the Incarnation. We're not talking just about a great mystery, a great miracle of God being made man, but we are also referring to a particular point, a particular time in history. It is and was an historical event. Jesus was fully human, fully man, as he was also fully divine and fully God. But the point is that this event happened. Now, the discrepancies between the 25th of December or the 6th of January for Christmas Day is really neither here nor there. There's kind of simple explanation, calendrical, as to that variance, but there's not time in today's homily to go into that now. But suffice to say that the 25th of December is, of course, 9 months from the 25th of March. But on this Feast of Expectation of the Blessed Virgin, as I say, let us turn our minds and our thoughts to the expectation that Our Lady must have had this week before giving birth. Now, of course, as everybody knows who knows anything about pregnancies, one cannot pinpoint the exact time of delivery. One does not know when the baby will exactly be born. And there's a wonderful, of course, figure there concerning the season of Advent itself and our preparation for the commemoration of not just the first coming, but also of the second coming of our Saviour. Our Lord himself tells us in the Gospel, "Who shall not know the hour or the day of it?" And indeed, for bless her, Mary, that was also true in her expectation. She would not have known then, on this date, 2,000 years ago, that 7 days later she would give birth. There might have been, and indeed probably were, older and female relatives, more experienced, who might have been able to guess roughly when a baby might be born. But it certainly wasn't as anything like as scientific as it is now, and even now it is not a sure science. You cannot be absolutely certain about a delivery date, unless of course one is being delivered by a caesarean, which of course is an operation. But otherwise, one cannot predict the day and time and day of it. And remember too, that according to the narrative, presumably at this point, Our Lady and St. Joseph are travelling on their way to Bethlehem to fulfil, of course, the decree of the Emperor Augustus of his census. So they are returning to the ancestral town of the House of David, and that was a long and arduous journey all the way from Nazareth in Galilee, a long way indeed, travelling almost the whole length of Palestine, of Israel. And the suggestion, of course, is that Our Lady was riding an ass on the back of a donkey. Imagine, brothers and sisters, a pregnant woman of about 8 to 9 months sitting on a donkey on a dirt track on a dusty road all the way from Galilee to Bethlehem. One wonders if Our Lady's expectation might have been that she could give birth at any minute, with all the bumps and the uncomfortableness of that journey. But at the same time too, as anyone who has been ever remotely connected with a pregnancy will know, there is a sense of expectation. There is a real sense of joy, of expectation, of an impending birth. For not just the parents, but for the family and for friends. No doubt, as was the usual custom in these days, they would have travelled some way in a convoy. No doubt some of them would have been joyful with the expectation of what would be Mary's delivery. So we can be certain that as arduous and as difficult as Our Lady's pregnancy and late term and her expectation might have been, at the same time, there would have been joy, there would have been hope. Everyone looking forward, none more so probably than Our Lady, to the delivery, to the birth. And so it is that this Feast of the Expectation today enables us, echoing the theme of Gaudete Sunday, rejoice in the Lord always, I say, and again I say, rejoice, for the Lord is at hand. And indeed, this feast reminds us that just 7 days now, we will commemorate that wonderful miracle of Bethlehem, that wonderful divine intervention in our history, in our concept of time, when God will be made one of us, when a Saviour of the world will be born, our Saviour, he who enables us, my brothers and sisters, to have the hope and expectation of heaven. We who ourselves have been reborn through baptism, now living
with the hope and expectation of heaven. Let us not lose sight in these busy days of shopping and preparation for the feast. Let us not lose sight of the joy of our expectation, of the joy of Our Lady's expectation. Let us try, my brothers and sisters, to find a few moments today, perhaps, to reflect on what expectation Our Lady must have had. This bizarre and yet wonderful pregnancy, this message from an angel, this heavenly apparition. And what it meant, and what it must have meant to Our Lady, who had not known man, but who then found herself pregnant, and who then was experiencing all that pregnant women experience, of that unique, growing and developing relationship between mother and child in the womb. But all of that connected with her knowledge that this was not going to be just any ordinary child, was not just any ordinary child, but one of huge and heavenly significance, one told by her would be the Son of God. And in our joyful then expectation and preparation, let us remember those wonderful words from the end of today's pericope from the prophecy of Isaiah. Behold, the virgin shall be with child and shall bear a son, and he shall be called Emmanuel. Fed on butter and honey, he will grow to the age of refusing what is bad, choosing what is good. Advent, of course, is not quite like Lent in terms of our penitential observance of the season. And indeed, many of us, I'm sure, have already begun to feast on butter and honey, on sweets and confectionery and chocolate and cake and mince pies, and we might already have had a few Christmas dinners by now with social events and occasions. But let us learn, which of course is the whole point of our Saviour coming to us, to refuse what is bad and choose what is good, especially in these last days of preparation and expectation. And for the rest of our lives too, knowing that however difficult it may be for us to seemingly overcome our own selves, our own will, yet nothing is impossible with God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Credo in unum Deum, Patrem omnipotentem, factorum caeli et terrae, visibilium omnium et invisibilium, et in unum Dominum Iesum Christum, filium Dei unigenitum, et ex Patri natum ante omnia saecula, Deum de Deo lumen de lumine, Deum verum de Deo vero, genitum non factum consustantialem Patri, pequem omnia factus sunt, qui prode nos homines, et prode nostrum salutem, descendi de caelis, et incarnatus est in Spiritus Sancto ex Maria Virgine, et homo factus est. Crucifixus etiam pro nobis sub Pontio Pilato passus et sepultus est, et res exiter sit est secundis scripturas, et descendere in caelum sedere dexteram Patris, et iterum venturus est cum gloria judicari vivos et mortuos, cuius reni non erit finis. Et in Spiritum Sanctum Dominum et fructificantem, qui ex Patri procedit, qui cum Patri et Filio semeretoritur cum glorificatur, qui locutus est per prophetas, et unam sanctam catholicam et apostolicam ecclesiam, confitio unu baptismo in missione peccatorum, et expecto resurrectionem mortuorum, et vitam venturi seculi. Amen.
Dominus vobiscum et cum spirito tuo.
Oremus.
Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui.
Orate, frates.
Urbe non vestum sacrificio in accettabile, fita potem patrimonio potem.
Suscipia Dominus sacrificio de manus mes, et larga gloria nomni sui, et utilità con coco nostro, totiusque plesi sui sa.
Omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Dominus vobiscum et cum spirito tuo. Sos un corda habemus ad Dominum. Gratias ad Amus Domino Deo nostro. Dignum et justum est. Verre dignum et justum est equam salutare nos tibi sempre et ubique gratias agere Domine Sancte Pater omnipotens aeterne Deus. Et in expectatione beate Mariae semper virginis caludare, benedicere et predicare, quae ut unigenitum tuum sancti spiritus in populatione concepit, et virginitatis gloriae permanente lumen aeternum mundo effudit, Iesum Christum Dominum nostrum. Perque majestatem tuum laudant angeli, adorant dominationes renunt potestates, Celi cerum pevetute se beate serfim socis ot etsioni concerebram. Un quibus en nostris voces ut emitiu best deplicamur, supplici confessione dicentes. Sanctus. 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 Dominus Deus sapeate, plenisum celi et terra gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis. Benedictus quae venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis.
nobis quoque peccatoribus.
Omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Ordemus, precepti salutaribus maliti de bene sociali compatia demus dice. Pater noster quies in caeli, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in caelo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris. Et ne nos inducas in tentationem, se libra nossa mal. Erra mia secula seculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit sempero vobiscum. Et cum spirito tuo.
Ecce omnius Dei, ecce qui tollit peccatum mundi. Domine non sum dignus, ut in tre subtectum meam, sed tantum de verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Domine nos dignus, ut in tres sententum meum sententum vivembo et senabitur anima mea. Domine nos dignus, ut in tres sententum meum sententum vivembo et senabitur anima mea.
Brothers and sisters watching Mass online and unable therefore to receive the Blessed Sacrament, we invite you now to make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee, and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen.
Ecce Virgo concipiet et pariet filium, et vocabit nomen eius, Emmanuel.
Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo.
Alleluia.
Gratiam tuam quaesmus Domine mensibus nostris infunde, utque angelum unciante Christi Filii tui incarnationem coniovimus, per passionem eius et crucem et resurrectionis gloriam peducamur, veriundum Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum Filium tuum, qui tecum vivit regna ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Ordinus.
imploramus Domine clementiam tuam, ut hei divina subsidia vitiis expiatus ad festa ventura nos preterent. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum filium tuum, videbum vimita regna ad unenitatis ritus sancti Deus, per omnia secura seculorum. Amen. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo. Ite missa est, Deo gratias. Sit nomen Domini benedictum et sognum godusque in saecula, audit orum nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci caelum et terra. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus. Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo, initium sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem, gloria tibi Domine. In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat ab Deum, et Deus erat verbum, hoc erat in principio ab Deum, omnium principum factus sunt, et sim factum est, nihil factum est. In ipso vita erat lux habem, lux in tenebris, luce de tenebre, non comprehenderum. Quum fuit homum in sucedeo quo nomine lat Ioannes, in veritate testimonibus, testimonibus veret lumine, et omnes credunt virum. Non erit in lux, et testimonibus veret lumine, erat lux vera con lumina ad omnem hominem venientem in mundum. In mundu erat mundus principum factus est, et mundus est non cognovit. In proprie venite somno receperunt, quod autem ceperunt, et detes potestatem filios Dei fieris, qui prendi nomine eius. Qui non sanguinibus, nec voluntati carnis, nec voluntati viri, sine externati sunt. Et verbum carnum factum est. Et habitavit in nobis, et vinimus gloriam eius, gloriam quasi unigenitia Patre, plenum gratiae meritatis. Deo gratias. Grace, Lord, is with thee, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve, to thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this vale of tears. Turn, thou most gracious advocate, thine eyes of mercy toward us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. O God, who art our refuge and our strength, look down in mercy on thy people who cry to thee, and by the intercession of the glorious and blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and St. Joseph, her spouse, and thy blessed apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all thy saints. In mercy, goodness, hear our prayers for the conversion of sinners and for the liberty and exaltation of our Holy Mother, the Church. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Holy Michael, Archangel, defend us in the day of battle, and be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust down to hell Satan and all wicked spirits who wander through the world for the ruin of souls. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy upon me, a sinner. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy upon me, a sinner. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy upon me, a sinner. May our heavenly patron, Saints Catherine and Wilfrid, pray for us. May St. Louvina pray for us. May St. Richard of Chichester pray for us. May Our Lady of Walsingham pray for us. May our holy guardian angels pray for us. May our heavenly patron saints pray for us. May Our Lady Queen of Heaven, all the angels and saints pray for us.